Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. I'm really glad you're here. If you are brand new here, my name is Fiddlin' Johnny and this is my fiddle channel and magic product review. And before we do any magic product review, we do a quick fiddle tune. So let's do Don Rich's Cajun Fiddle. Well, it's a bit of a snippet from Cajun Fiddle. All right, glad you're all here, but I know you're here for the magic product review, and today we're doing Steve Thompson's Appearing Glass. Stick around, we'll get right into it. All right, everyone, let's get right into Steve Thompson's Appearing Glass. What is Steve Thompson's Appearing Glass? Basically, you have a bag and you can make just about anything appear in it. On this one, it's sold as sort of like you make a liquid appear in a glass in this bag. That's it. But it's better if we do a demo, isn't it? So I just got done doing a demo. Let's go ahead and watch that demo. And I'll say just before we go into the demo, like my bag now is a bit messy. You might see some of that as we talk about it because of the liquid that I'm using. We'll talk about the liquid when we come back. All right, let's watch the quick demo. Hello, everyone. Thought I'd do a quick demo of Steve Thompson's Appearing Glass. Now, you'll all start out with your magic bag. And can I just say how much I love my magic bag? It produces just some of my favorite things. You can show your magic bag quite easily. Yes, yes, I call it my magic bag. You can show that it's completely empty. No problem with that at all. I should mention, why do I love my magic bag? I love my magic bag because it produces some of my most favorite things. So you can, again, see the bag is empty there for you. And the reason I love that it produces some of my favorite things, I just imagine holding something that I really like, tossing it up in the air, and there, it magically appears. Now, what did I wish for? I wished for a pint of Guinness. Okay, it's not quite a pint of Guinness, and the reason it's not a pint is because I keep practicing this, and well, now I have less Guinness. That is a demo of Steve Thompson's Appearing Glass. All right, thanks everyone. Oh, you're back already. I didn't even finish my drink yet. All right, well, you just saw the demo. I hope that was helpful. Of course, you know, it's, I haven't been out and performing this with lots and lots of polish, but you do get a sense of what this does, what it looks like, etc. So that is Steve Thompson's Appearing Glass demo on that. Let's talk about what do you get. So in this box, produced by Vanishing Ink, you're going to get a dog barking in the middle of your review. Hey dog, excuse me for a second. Get the dog to be quiet. Hey! All right, where was I? I think I was mentioning what do you get from this, from Vanishing Ink. Well, you're going to get your bag, boom. You're going to get a glass, Guinness not included, and a stopper for your plastic glass that you get. And you're going to get a tutorial video. Now, the tutorial video is 20 minutes in length. You stream it through the Vanishing Ink website. It is not downloadable. Important for folks to know if that is a deal breaker for you. But that's what you get. You get paper bag, glass, stopper, 20-minute video, tutorial. And you're going to get a bonus tutorial, by the way, on there, which is called The Appearing Cube, and it's taught by Jason Silverman. The Appearing Glass is taught by Steve Thompson, the creator of this this release. All right, so let's talk about how are the instructions. So the instructions are 20 minutes in length. And usually I say, 20 minutes is just not near enough. Steve goes through all of the essential elements that you need in order to perform this. You'll even get some subtleties. Could there be more subtleties, Todd? Absolutely. Could there be a live performance thrown on there? Absolutely. Wish there was, but there wasn't. But despite that it's only 20 minutes in length, you'll get what you need because it's pretty simple and straightforward. All right. Also, I'd say Steve, a good teacher. He's a nice pace. He's not rushing through it 20 minutes. He's sort of taking his time with it, which I really like. And then I think one of the other things about the what I like about the tutorial, it's shot nicely, it sounds great, all that sort of stuff. The fact that they do have the extra Jason Silverman on there teaching Cube in paper bag, I like that because it demonstrates that this is just not about making a glass beverage appear, that you can have anything that would fit into a paper bag. In essence, you should be able to do with this or near close to, if you can load it in there, it will work. So I do like that. Let's talk about how is the gimmick. I'm going to bring the gimmick up close to the camera so you can see it. And what I'm going to point out here is that the nice thing about this is that it feels like it is very showable to your audience. You can show it on all sides. You can show the inside of it, no problem whatsoever. There's nothing to see. You can have your audience member put their hands in there, and you're good. The nice thing is that you can fold this baby up, carry it in your jacket pocket, and when you're ready to perform, you can just go ahead, pull it out, and you're ready to go and show it empty. Or you have a receipt in there or whatever you wanted to, and then can proceed to it. As you probably already know, it is made out of Tyvek. Tyvek is not really paper, it's more of a plastic, so it's durable and should last a really long time. If it gets dirty, you can clean it. And I don't know if you can see this, but like, because I performed with the Guinness, I'm already getting some brown spots on the bottom of my bag. And I will need to obviously wipe that down with a damp cloth to be able to clean that out. I've got on the inside in the very bottom, it has splashed, so I've got a little browning going in there. But it should clean up because it is sort of a plasticky material. The one thing I think I would add is, like, I don't know that I would do like soda drinks in this appearing because of the sugar, it can get sticky. And I would probably just have my can of soda appear in here, crack it open, and then drink it as part of my routine, because otherwise the splashing in here might make it sort of sticky over time. And that's just me, something I don't like about it. But the gimmick is durable. While it's not fully examinable, meaning like at the end or at the very beginning, I'm not handing it out to my audience members and letting them inspect it. They would immediately or pretty quickly figure out what's going on. But it performance is structured in a way that it gives the appearance that the bag is just normal, that there's nothing odd about it. You can have your spectator reach in and actually pull out whatever object you'd like them to out of the bag, which would add a whole nother level of, I think, convincer that the bag is nothing fishy about the bag. It's also one of those things where it's nice that it's like, yeah, it just hides in plain sight. And I know that's a cliche in magic, but your gimmick hides in plain sight, no one will ever freaking know. One other thing I think I would have liked with this, teaching how to make your own gimmicked bag, but of course they probably want you just to buy new ones, but look, it's not rocket surgery here. You should be able to, if you own it, if you want to make your own over time, just go and buy some Tyvek, sheet of Tyvek paper, and figure out how to make a bag, and you can make your own. So anyway, don't probably really need the instructions for that. Would have liked it, but hey, it is what it is. All right, so let's talk about what the skill level is. The skill level, in my opinion, is an advanced beginner. If this is your very first trick that you've ever purchased, can you perform it? Yes. But I do believe in the hands of somebody who is a more advanced beginner, it will be probably a little bit better. mostly because you have to do a load, and I think that requires a little more confidence and practice. So all very doable by a beginner magician, but I think the more you've been doing magic and the longer, the easier and more confidence you have to do moves like loading the bag in essence. So it does require some misdirection. That's all taught on the tutorial. But I would assume most of you understand that there's some misdirection that's involved in there. All right, let's talk about what are some of the pros. This is a worker. Honestly, this is something that any worker could be using and put immediately into their set, and I think they'd be pretty happy about it. I love that the bag looks completely normal. They often use the cliche about pack small, plays big. This clearly falls into that category. It does pack small and plays big. I like that it's durable with the Tyvek paper. It should last a very long time. And the effect is really good. It does look like real magic because of the freedom you have to show the bag empty and pulling it out flat. Like there's, how are you gonna get, you know, a glass of liquid in there? So it does look very magical, I think. And I do also like the fact that you are not limited to just producing a glass of liquid. You can produce whatever you would fit into this open size paper bag there. All right, let's talk a little bit about the cons. I don't see this as completely, totally impromptu magic. For me, at least, it's the type of gimmick that I'm probably using in a parlor type set or a small stage type of performance. It is sold and taught that you can also use this in for a walk around. I think that's taught well enough on the tutorial and the ways that you would perform it in walk around, but again, that's probably, let's say, advanced beginner. I guess if you've been hired to do walk around, you're a skilled enough magician and you can use it for walk around. One of the things I would add about that is you don't have to be carrying around the liquid if you're doing walk around all the time. You could just use one of the glasses that are sitting on the table in which for the folks that you're performing for. So that is possible as well. I would also mention, as I talked about earlier, like this bag might get a little dirty over time, but because it's Tyvek, you should be able to wash it down. But you may learn over time ways to make sure that you're just keeping it as pristine as possible. Although it does look good for the bag to be a little bit used, I think it does hide a little bit better the more worn in it is, the gimmicked aspect of the bag. All right, let's talk a little bit about who will like this, and I think as I mentioned earlier, I think the sweet spot for this is a small stage type of performance or platform performance or parlor performance. That's the sweet spot. You control all the conditions. The angles are easiest to manage in that type of setting. There are some angle issues, but they're minimal, and I think for anybody through the tutorial we'll be able to manage those. I think if you're a bar magician, it could be great as well because you're making, you could make a beverage up here that somebody has ordered in the bag. So it's nice in that respect as well. Or anybody who does magic that includes bags, you might be able to use this bag instead of maybe one that you already use and use it across multiple effects. Now in the United States, it costs $39.95. It feels just a hair expensive to me for a Tyvek bag and a glass that you don't have to actually use the glass if you don't want to. But with that said, given that it's, you know, it's handmade and the time it takes, it's probably at a price point, given what it takes to make these, as reasonable, that also includes a level of profit for them. But if you're a worker, it's a no-brainer. Pays for itself immediately and does the job. So a lot of times when I talk about price, it's also subjective in terms of what's the right price and affordable for somebody. If you're somebody who just performs for your mates down at the pub, I don't know if this is the best. It's okay, it's great, but you definitely have to be planning for it. I think somebody who's a worker, they have spots in performances, I think, where this would probably work really well. All right, I think that's it for me. I think if I had to summarize, the effect I think looks awesome, looks really cool. The bag works as advertised. I found all the ad copy and the teasers for it spot on, nailed it. Didn't feel like there was any deceptive advertising there. And I think if you're interested in performing it, it's probably gonna be best if you're doing small stage or parlor, and keep it clean. That's it. So, all right. I hope that is helpful for you. I certainly find this sort of effect a really fun effect. I don't know that I'll be performing it a lot personally, because it doesn't sort of fit maybe what I do, but you know, that could change over time. It's nice to have and know that maybe I will use it should I like it, because I like the effect. All right, if you purchased it, leave a comment down below. Share what your experiences are on this today and what your perspective is. It would be really helpful. Also, leave a comment just to say hi. And I know if you haven't hit that like button right now. I'll wait for you. That's it. Go ahead and hit it. It's appreciated. It certainly helps with the algorithm for the video to get promoted. And also hit that subscribe button if you have not yet subscribed. And thank you to everyone who has subscribed. 75% of you watchers on this channel are not subscribed. So what are you waiting for? Subscribe to the channel, everyone. Really appreciate it if you do and those who have. All right. I'm Fiddlin' Johnny. And remember to keep fiddling around with your magic. I'll see y'all next time. Bye-bye.